My name is Sasha, the girl behind Legends from Mom's Closet, and this is my book. But it's not just a book. We focus on dress up, learning, creativity, and saving our oceans. I couldn't fit all the legends I wanted to in my diary, but that's okay, because now I can share the legends in history and the legends of our days. Well, speaking about that, today... Welcome back, everybody, to my new segment, Day with a Legend. Today, we're going to be learning about the legendary ballroom couple, the 10 times world Latin champions, Riccardo Cocchi and Yulia Zagoruychenko. So let's jump right into the interview.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi, guys. How are
Hello,
you?
Hello, good. Thank you. How are you
nice
guys?
To see you.
Oh, nice to see you.
Thank you so
this
much.
Is for you.
Thank you.
All right, so how are you guys today?
Oh, we are so good. We're so excited.
And how do you guys like Miami?
Wow. Miami's
beautiful.
We love Miami, yes.
Come on, it's the best place ever.
How's the beach? Did you guys go?
Love it.
We do.
Yes. Yeah, it's a lot of fun to go swimming and everything.
Yes, we definitely spend a little bit of time in the beach and then teaching.
Of course, yes. Us too. It's very important for us to raise awareness about ballroom dancing because a lot of the kids that I know, when I tell them that I'm a ballroom dancer, they say, oh, what's that? I don't know. What is ballroom dancing? Can you explain? So I do really want for the younger generation and other children and adults to know a lot more about ballroom dancing.
Absolutely, absolutely. I think it's a great thing.
Well, ballroom dancing, I mean, it's something that we personally start in very early age. What is ballroom dancing? Ballroom dancing is definitely, it's one of the dancing discipline that you're doing together, dancing together. It's called ballroom because they used to be dance in a ballroom and in a hold position. Now, there is a two part of ballroom international dance competition. It's the standard and in the Latin. Somebody say even ballroom is a standard. It's a synonymous of standard. But as we know, there is a five dance and five dance. Five dance, it's for the standard. It's a waltz, tango, Venus waltz, slow fox, and quick step. And in Latin American, it's the cha-cha-cha, samba, rumba, paso doble, and jive.
That's what we do,
That's
Latin American dancing.
Yes. Well, since I've been ballroom dancing for years now, it's shown me that it does take a lot of patience and determination. Since you guys have had so many amazing titles, how do you keep up your motivation?
It's a good question.
Yeah,
the first,
very good.
When I was your age, actually, it drove me to be the champion. I don't know why, but I had in my mind, I want to be the top. The top, it was the world champion. And that's what I start with, and that's what my goal. When we achieve, actually, when we achieve this goal, world champion, my motivation was actually happiness, because I really, really happy when I'm dancing. Whatever it's make me happy,
sure.
It's actually dancing. And in a way, dancing also make me very, very sad too, because as you know, it's like no middle. Or you're very happy or you're very sad. It could be many reasons. As you know, it's a lot of challenge, it's a lot of determination, and you know, sometimes not a good result make you so sad. And I think dancing make me that sad. But when you achieve good and result and it feels good, I'm the happiest person in the world.
Yeah.
That's for me.
The secret is to keep yourself inspired. Obviously, when your age is a different priority than later on in your life. Right? In your age, I think it's the most important thing is to understand that it can be fun, but there is a lot of discipline.
Yes, of course.
And the discipline sometimes takes some of your time off from the schedule. And you have to invest in what you're doing for the future. You know, like your age is probably the most precious ever. And whatever you invest in this time, you will enjoy in the future. And it's important to keep yourself inspired and motivated.
You guys have had dance different routines in each type of dance.
Yes.
What do you think is your overall favorite dance move that you guys have danced together?
Ooh, that's
we
a
have
good
a few.
Question.
We have a few. Definitely, we have. I think very well known with the jive chicken walks. What
well,
we did the chicken walks with the overturn.
Yes.
That
because it happened by mistakes, right?
Yeah.
We went in California, and working with Heidi, Don Ismer's wife, we were doing some play with the routine and
the
things
routine,
like this.
Something and, like change maybe.
And we said, come on, Heidi, you have to find something new, okay? Yeah. I was just kidding, you know? I was just not really asking something, but, you know, teasing each other and things like. And she's like, okay, why don't you try to switch? I'm like,
switch?
Yeah, I do the chicken walks and switch.
And switch.
Heidi, it's very difficult. Try! And we tried, you know, it happened. It's like, actually, it's cool. It's possible to do it. So since then, we did it.
Yeah, I think it's...
It was very challenging at the beginning, but it's good.
When I watched you guys dance on your final competition, it was here in Florida. It was so beautiful.
Thank you.
I saw you guys do it in the jive. It was amazing.
Yes, thank you.
We had a good competition that night. We enjoyed because everybody knew that was our last competition. And not like our last dance, but the last competition. We give it all, we enjoy. We have, was like a crossing of emotion.
Yeah.
And ultimately, I thought the best night we ever had. I mean, I don't know about dancing, but emotionally, yes.
Emotionally, definitely. Yeah, definitely, I was scared to dance the last competition because I didn't know how it's gonna go. Because, you know, as you know, you prepare yourself maximum, and we do always. But then on the day of the competition, you don't know how your body will react. You know, even yourself. Sometimes it's good, and sometimes you cannot explain. But it doesn't. But it doesn't go anything, you know. And I was like, I'm scared. I wanted that it's gonna be good because it's the last competition. And honestly, with you, every competition we dance our 100%. We always do.
Yes,
small competition, big, we give it all. And I was thinking, like, how it's going to be the last competition? I don't know, because we always give our best. Yeah, we give 100%. And then we did first dance, first round, and audience stood up. And I'm like, that is the difference. Because everybody were like, so much, you know, with you.
Yes, that's the best feeling.
That's the best feeling.
Amazing.
And I think that was the last competition, what is going to, you know, stay in my memory forever.
Of course, and in mine too, when I saw you guys dance for the first time. It was amazing.
Sweet.
Thank you. Thank you. Yulia, what is one dancewear accessory that you couldn't live without?
That's a great question. Actually, I have two accessories, but I think if I should pick, it's my fringe skirt. I will never be without the fringe skirt.
When you guys watch other couples, do you find yourself judging their performance or enjoying the show?
When we are competing with them, or we just like...
When you just watch them.
Would you watch? Sometimes we have to watch and judge them. And as much as I try to enjoy the event, my duty is to judge them. So I have to kind of select the couples. Mm-hmm. But I'm not doing it in a bad feeling, you know? Like, I'm not trying to judge them in a bad way. I just try to find the best out of each, instead of the worst things to...
No, it's... When you're like watching them for fun without judging.
Yes. For me, actually, it's what I'm doing, I'm learning. I'm learning by mistakes. For some reason, the first thing, I mean, I admire, but the first thing I'm always, it's come to me, okay, I should do this, I should not do that. I kind of learning from them.
Yeah.
What's the biggest competition you guys were ever competed on?
The biggest. Well, we danced a lot of big competition. Probably
Blackpool, I would say.
Yeah,
it's one of
really
the
bigger. Bigger as a importance or bigger as a amount of couple dancing.
Important.
Worlds probably. I would say world is number one. Mm-hmm. You see, as a dancers, ballroom dancers, everybody always think about Blackpool. It's the top of the competition. Yes. But you have to always remember that one day when you retire and you say to somebody that you won Blackpool, they're like, what? But if you say like, I won one title, World Championship, everybody gonna be like, wow, it's a World Championship. So ultimately, you have to remember titles are based on World, European, if you dance European, and World Cup and things like this. That's what is number one. It probably, the World Championship is the one we put more effort.
Yeah, for
right?
sure. For
and
sure.
Of course, Blackpool.
Blackpool too.
Once you win the world, you don't want to lose Blackpool. So.
Of course. What was your reaction when you won your first world championship?
Oh,
shocked.
Amazing. Amazing shocked. Was. Yeah, we were shocked.
Riccardo, what are the three must-haves to being a great dance partner?
Okay, well, that's a million-dollar question.
Great question.
What do you need to have? Respect, discipline, probably work ethic.
Fantastic.
Work ethic, like working hard. Like, actually, but you don't have to have it, but you have to willing to do it, to do the job. You know, like, I don't know, I'm Italian, so I'm not willing to work, but sometimes we know if you want to have a result, you need to work. And the things is like, between us, she was the pusher. She pushed me to do it, and you know, I agree because we need to do it, so I'm okay to do it. But I think probably the most important thing, so long term, is respect. Respect towards yourself, respect towards your partner.
Yeah.
And regardless what happened, regardless what you're doing, you have to remember, the one word, it can change completely the result of your future or anything else.
You see, he didn't say talent.
No.
Not necessary. Talent is just
extra. Just need to know how to work.
Exactly.
Absolutely.
I believe in talent, but I really believe on the work ethic. Or yeah. The fact that you are, how much energy, how much work, attention you need to put in what you're doing.
Were there any moments for any of you where you guys wanted to give up on dancing?
It was. But only one day. I'm like, that's it. I don't want to do it. I don't want to. Next
luckily,
day I wake up.
And luckily, okay. Not on the same
I
time.
Go, yes.
Because if both of us want to give up on the same times, then it's a problem. Then you give up. Yeah.
Yes, it definitely was.
You know, a beautiful thing about ballroom dancing is also because you is a two person dancing together.
Yeah.
It's a team, teamwork, right? Yeah. If one is feel down, the other one has the duty or the drive to support the other person. Understand? And support the other person. Why? Because it's your teammate.
Yeah.
So if you need support, you give support. And sometimes if you need a support, you of course it would be nice to have it, but if you don't have it, well, c'est la vie, what can you do? But I think it's nice because together you can
work
together.
Teamwork does everything.
Always.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yes.
It's the key to success.
Right.
Especially in something like dancing where you have a partnership.
Yeah, I believe so.
I agree. Good girl.
There's so many ballroom dance movies that are super interesting. Since you guys are experts, which one is your favorite? Because mine is Shall We Dance.
Shall We Dance?
Yeah, Shall We Dance. Very famous.
It's
yeah.
Nice, isn't it? There
well,
are several.
Yeah, it's a few nice.
It's one very old, Strictly Ballroom.
Oh, I've watched
also
that one.
Strictly
it was amazing.
Ballroom.
The Australian
I loved
one.
It.
Yeah.
Me and Sasha, we were eating at the restaurant and we knew you would say those two.
Is it?
yes, we predicted.
nice.
You know which one we also love? Take the Lead.
Oh,
Take
I
the
love
lead.
That
I
one.
Watched it.
Yes, that was amazing.
Actually,
and it shows that anybody can dance.
Yeah, exactly. I love this movie. Inspiring.
There is a story that when we start to dance, okay?
Together?
Yeah, together. I moved to New York. To dance with Yulia, and we went to a private studio, and the studio was
somewhere
Pierre Doulet studio.
Small studio, we
right?
Didn't know it's a Pierre Doulet.
No, but it was like a Pierre Doulet studio. Pierre Doulet, it's a famous man that
he danced cabaret.
He was a cabaret dancer,
yes,
but the most important thing is that he connected the dancing between people. Like, you know, dancing was always very much an elite a discipline, a sport. That's why it used to not be for everybody, right? Only in a certain age, an elite, so elegant, ballroom dancing and stuff like this. What did you understand that in a school, in a young age, people lacking of discipline and also connection between the other person. So what he was able to do, it's take the people from the street, from the Bronx, from Brooklyn, and put them together and dancing together. And they discover another world, respect of discipline, kind of music, of dancing together, get hold to the other person, and a part that where people kind of not ignore it, but you know, assuming it's okay. And he used the tools of a dancer to create a big society, a better society. And so we went to the studio,
yeah.
And we were struggling with what part of our routine. And this guy was sitting, and he looked at. He said, "Do you need help?"
And we did like a kind of trick, you know, like. somebody want to help us, and we could not make it, like we were like struggling. I said, shall I help you guys?
Yeah, it's okay. And then we're like, it's okay, thank you. And, you know, I didn't want to disturb people. I would just like try to work myself on it. And then didn't work. I said, actually, you know what? Can I use your help? So yeah, sure, no problem. I said, show me what you're doing. So we did something, and he's like, oh, why don't you do like this out? So we tried, I was like, oh yeah, actually, it's working. Thank you so much.
Was he a dancer?
Okay. Okay. So. And then, and you know, me, older than you, obviously,
yes.
But coming from Europe and knowing the name of Pierre Dulay, but I never met Pierre Dulay personally.
Me too, I never met him.
So, long story short, we got to check out, so we pay for the floor fee, and the guy, and I was speaking with the guy, and I looked, they had some pictures with Antonio Banderas as this guy next to it. Banderas was part of the move. So, and I asked to the guy there, sorry to ask you, who is this one? He said to me, you don't know who is him? I said, I'm sorry, I don't. And he said to me, well, that's Pierre Dulay. You know, like cold shower. I would never think to be able to meet Pierre Dulay. And I said, I'm so sorry, I didn't know this was Pierre Dulay. And then he came back and he said, I'm so sorry, man. I didn't think I would be able to know Pierre Dulay. It's like, if you go to Fred Astaire's studio, you would never think to meet Fred Astaire, right?
Yes. So, here's a fun question. Okay. Would you rather dance on the beach or on top of a mountain?
Okay.
Definitely not on the mountain for me. I am scared of height.
No.
Me too.
It depends.
I'm sure I'll
we dance on the beach. Actually, you know what? We did both.
Oh yeah, we danced on the
beach. We danced on the beach with a professional floor, like they build the floor on the beach, seriously.
On the wood, but also
we danced
on the sand.
Also on the sand. For our retirement, so we did a video, we danced on the sand.
Yeah, we did a video, we did retirement this.
Uh-huh. Oh, actually, I've seen, I saw the video on the competition.
Yes. Wow, you remember. Good.
A lot of people and kids who are dancers older than me and my age look up to you guys. What is something in ballroom dancing that you can only learn with experience?
You cannot cheat time. This is one thing, like when we start to dance together, we would like to have a result straight away.
Yeah.
Okay, but not because we thought we were the best, because we were willing to work hard. And I said, you know, if we work hard and we might have a little bit of talent and, you know, work ethic, we could get, you know, mathematically, you could get it. You can't. And it's not about politics, it's not about anything else. You just need the physical time to develop yourself.
Yeah.
It's not something that you can speed it up. You can put all your best efforts, but years by the years is different. And when they told us at the beginning, like, would you do right now? I was like, I'm working hard. How many hours you want me to do? I'll do in a week. It doesn't matter how much you put. You have to work that amount of hours, but still, the gelling together, the working together, and everything is working with the time.
Yes, that's, of course. Time is the most important ingredient.
And another thing I will advise you too, for now to the future, if you're serious to dance, don't split. Don't split, don't change your partner. A lot of people change the partner and they think like, okay, well, I didn't have a result with this girl or with this boy. I go to the next one and maybe I'm gonna stay another month. Oh, I have this one, okay, let me go to that one. Every time you start with another, you reset.
At least as long as you can, stay more longer together. Develop this, develop your skills, develop your technique, partnering.
Yeah. Why did you start to dance?
Well, I started to dance because my mom kind of forced me. But then, no. But then, like, right when I started dancing, like, I'm doing this my whole life.
You great. See, but most of the boys like that.
Yeah,
it's
me
not
too.
A lot. They just go just because parents force, but then they love it.
When I was around, just turned 5, we went to this theater to see Alice in Wonderland, the show. And there was a lot of dancing and they were dancing together and I really enjoyed it. And I was like, Mom, can I try dancing too? I really want to be a dancer. So my mom took me to the studio and I fell in love with it.
Beautiful story.
Yeah.
Great.
Yeah.
One last question.
Yes.
What is some advice that you would give to your younger selves?
You see, I have no regrets what I did in my life. It's not like, I don't think looking back, I would do anything different than what I did. But if I would give an advice, I don't know. I just think probably to enjoy a little bit more. And it's not about clubbing or get out or enjoy with the friends. It's not about this. And even though I didn't have so much time to do with that, but sometimes I'm very hard with myself, and I take serious a little bit too much what I'm doing. When it could be done in a different way. But anyway, it was the only way I did it, so I love it and I have no regrets for it.
Well, that's really good.
And you, Yulia?
For me, actually, it's interesting because I came from the small town, from not a rich family. And, for me, dancing was the only thing what I love and make me happy. And I always believe I'm gonna make it. So I want just a little bit give you this kind of advice, because everything is possible. Just if you really, really want and you go for it and you're gonna make it any way how it's possible to do. Even I left my country, I came to America because of dancing.
At what
left
age?
My 21 years old.
Still young.
Yes. Yeah, still young, I think. Yeah. Yeah. I didn't have so much like childhood, but everything was about competition, next dancing, improving dancing, keep going, and I achieved what I wish to. So it is possible. I would never believe it's possible, but I was going there. But honestly, if I think now, wow, I did it. How come I did it?
Like, yeah, and you have to believe. Yeah. I believe.
believe.
You know, like, I like when they say, if the dream is not, it doesn't scare you, it's not big enough. So you always have to aim for the maximum. When you aim for that maximum, whatever you can get, it's way more than what you wish. So I think you should believe that it's gonna happen and work yourself to make it happen.
And have a risk a little bit.
I take
was risky.
Risk, eh?
Yeah, take the risk. Don't be, in a kind of comfortable zone.
We have a couple of short, yes or no questions.
Yes, go for it. Yeah.
Would you like straight or curly hair?
Ooh. Curly.
Straight.
I know,
that's why
yes,
I like straight.
Because every morning I'm curly, like Riccardo every morning straight.
yeah, that's just hard work actually.
Books or movies?
Movies.
I would say most of the time I used to do books and then movies. Now I'm doing movies and books because
me too.
I like especially when the movie is made on the book. I like to read it after, just to have an idea or go more on details and to see how much.
So that doesn't, the movie kind of spoils the book for me.
Yeah.
I know.
When I read the book and I had my own movie and I watched the movie, I was kind of disappointed in a way, the way it went to.
But yeah, because you have your interpretation, imagination
yeah.
and then you see in the movie, oh, it's different actually.
Yeah. Yes, like sometimes you can imagine characters like so tall and then they come out the other side.
Exactly.
Do you prefer sweet or salty?
Salty.
Sweet. Yeah. Sweet for sure.
For me, salty. I like salty.
I like sweet. Yeah. I feel like all kids like sweet though.
Yeah, I'm already still young. I'm a kid already. I change into back, like. And you, what do you like?
I like sweet.
You like sweet too.
Of course.
Excuse
everybody.
Me.
It's okay. It's okay.
I'm younger.
You're gonna have more sweets.
Oh, don't change now.
It depends.
Too late.
Thank you guys so much for being here today and letting us learn so much more about your legendary dancing careers.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for this opportunity. I hope we can share.
Thank you so much for coming.
Vivía mi modo, cuando me conocí y recibí